Hello, Dr. Nitin here. Last few days I was in Singapore on a very hectic schedule, conducted 18 sessions there, and that's why I could not put any videos on YouTube or Instagram. But now I'm back and we are going to get started with Word table of contents. Why do you need table of contents? Because long documents, so proposals, research papers, review documents, reports, thesis, all of them need table of contents. Don't create table of contents manually. There's an automatic way of doing it. What is table of contents? Well, it's just a list of topics, and for each topic, which page does it appear on? So there are two components: what and where. The where part means the page number is anyway managed by Word. You don't have to do anything. So the only thing you have to do is the what part. So how do you tell Word this is my topic? By applying styles, home tab styles. By default, you will see heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, but there are 9 levels available. So start applying styles. If you want shortcut, Control Alt 1, 2 and 3. If you use heading styles 4 onwards, there are no shortcuts, but you can just modify style, shortcut and put your own shortcuts. Easy. We'll use this sample file to learn how to create TOC. You can download it. Link is given in the description. Table of contents is relevant if the document is going to be printed and then people are going to read it. If people are not going to print the document, you do not need the traditional table of contents. We have a better online version. It's not called table of contents. You go to the view tab, it's called navigation pane. This gives you a live table of contents. This gives you the heading 1, 2, 3, 4, the entire structure. In fact, this is interactive, so you can even collapse it to main topics first, then expand on the topic, and then go exactly where you want. First of all, you go to the place where you actually want to insert the table of contents. When you press enter, make sure the heading style applied is normal. If by mistake you applied heading 1, that is not a good idea because it'll add another empty entry in the navigation pane. So if you do see something like this, click on that, go to that place, apply normal. You would expect it to be in insert menu, but no, it's in the references menu. The references, table of contents, there are automatic tables and manual table. Both automatic tables are the same except for the title itself. This is called content. This is called table of contents. So I'm just going to click on it and it's done. It has already created the table of contents based on what we have written there. Now let's see some problems which immediately surface. When there was no table of contents, introduction was of course starting on page number 1. But the fact that we added the table of contents, it has now gone to page 2. But in the table of contents, it is still showing it as page 1. In order to update the table, make sure your cursor hovers on the table. When you click inside, you will see update table option. It does give you two options. For the time being, say update entire table. If the document is small, it's always safer to use the second option. The first option makes sense when it's a really large document and you don't want it to waste time detecting headings and subheadings. For now, update entire table. Now it has done the job. So remember to update the table of contents before you send the final version to someone or you print it. Now let's understand how did it create the table of contents. I go to references, table of contents and say custom table of contents. And here is exactly what happened just now. It has used level 3. That means up to level 3, 1, 2 and 3. If I increase this level, because I do have up to level 4 in my table of contents, and just click OK. Now it is giving me this dialogue or asking me a question, because right now there is already a table of contents and I went to custom option. Do you want to customize this one itself? Or you want to add that one as a separate? So we want to replace this. And now you will notice the table of contents itself spread across multiple pages, and because it is including heading 4 as well. Now I'm going to reduce this granularity to show only level 1 content. You already know how to do it. Click on table of contents, custom table of contents, reduce it to 1, click OK and say replace. So now this is only higher level table of contents. And now of course introduction is on the first page. So that's how you customize table of contents. There are other things you should know. The tab leader means these dots. They can be customized, hyphen and so on. You have the choice of showing page numbers, and usually we right align the page numbers. But remember, this is print preview. There is also a web preview, a simple Word document in page layout view. When you zoom in, the text is going to get cut truncated. The more you zoom in, the more text will get cut off. But if you want to zoom in and prevent any truncation of text, you go to web view. So go to view, web layout. So it just changes the whole Word document to something like a web page. Now there are no page numbers. It's just a continuous web page. And now if you zoom in, see what is happening here. When I zoom in, doesn't matter how much you zoom in, text will not get truncated. Now what happens to the table of content in web view? Because it's a web page kind of thing, notice there are no page numbers, so page numbers simply disappear, and we still have this navigation as before. Long documents may need two table of contents, one at high level and one detail. You go to references, table of contents, custom table of contents, and I just want the high level one. That means heading one only. And we will call this main table of contents. I'll just go below, and again I'm going to add another table of contents. Table of contents, regular table of contents. So you have a base table of content and detailed table of content. Simple, easy, effective. The formats of the table themselves, by default it is like this. So go through available types of formats and choose the one which is most suitable for your content and your target audience. We can further customize the look and feel of the table of contents by deciding how each heading level looks in the table. So go to Contents, Custom Table of Contents, Modify, and there you will see multiple styles. Heading 1 level or Outline Level 1, TOC 1 style is applied, TOC 2 and so on. Just for demo purpose, I'm going to change how the TOC 1, that means Introduction, Word, PowerPoint, will look. This is the sample currently. Say Modify. This is the style modification dialog. For simplicity, I'm going to change this color to purple, and that should reflect immediately as soon as I change this. So we have full control over the look and feel of the table of contents. The options dialog actually tells you how the table of contents is created. By default, styles are used. You can also see that not only heading styles, but you can include other styles also in this. So you can also include text which has an outline level applied but does not have a style applied. As an example, I want this sentence to be a part of table of contents, but I don't want to apply a standard heading style to it. I'm going to say right click, paragraph settings, outline level is body text. I want to say no, this is outline level 2, and then OK. And now I'm going to insert a table of contents, but before I do that, I'm going to say options and also include outline levels. And notice this has become a part of TOC, although it does not have a heading style applied. For really complex documents, you need headings with numbering 1, 2, 2.1 and so on. Don't do it manually. Just click in any area where there is some heading style applied. Bullets, numbering, multi-level numbering. Open this and choose this one. And that's it. You get numbering. References, table of contents, new table of contents. The word table of contents itself gets a numbering sometimes. And because of that, your actual topic number 1 becomes topic number 2. So all that you have to do is go to the table of contents, backspace, remove that unwanted number, refresh the TOC, and you're done. Complex documents contain tables. And like we have table of contents, we also need a table of tables. If you go to references, insert caption, you can manually add the caption for a table. But usually we go to auto caption. Auto caption allows you to choose any specific type. In this case, Microsoft table. I'm going to use the label called table. And for numbering purpose, it's going to be automatic. And I'm also saying include chapter number, and the chapter number comes from heading 1. All this has already been done, so this is one table. Like that, there are multiple tables in this document. To insert a table of tables, you go to references and say insert a table of figures. And here, the caption you choose as table. And once you do that, it actually adds a table of tables. Simple, easy, effective. Look at this document. This is the cover page. Table of contents start from the second page. This itself requires multiple pages, and my real content is starting here, which is physically page number 4. So if I want proper numbering, regular page number, insert page number, top of page is just not going to cut it, because all of them got page numbers. I don't want page numbers here. I want page numbers here, but I want them to be Roman numbers, and I don't want them to spill over here. For this page, I want page number 1, 2, 3. Actually, on the first page, I don't even want to show the page number. It should start from this one with 2. In order to do this, we have to understand how headers and footers work. Currently, the header footer for all pages is same. We want to have different set of numbering scheme for this page, these two pages, and rest of the pages. So there are three distinct types of page numbering we want to handle. And a group of pages which have the same property, same behavior, should be in a separate section. We have never seen sections, so right click on the status bar and enable display of sections. Now my document is currently page 1, section 1. Even if I go to the last page, which is page 11, it is still section 1. These page breaks I am deleting. It's just a single document right now. So now, wherever I want a different page numbering, header, footer behavior, I want a new section. So I'm going to add a section here. Go to layout, break. I want a section break and a page break. And now notice, when I click here, it is section 2. Very good. Same thing I'm going to do. I'm going to add a page break, next page. Now this is section 3, as you can see. Very good. Now, the moment I put page numbers, there is one more thing to be done. First of all, I don't want page numbers here. I go here and add page numbers. Okay. Insert page number. Now, again, what has happened? The page number came here and it did go all over the place. That's not what I want. Why did that happen? Because headers and footers are linked to each other. So this is header for section 2. But let's zoom in. What is it saying? Same as previous. That means it is linked to the previous section header. I don't want that link. So I click on this and unlink it. Now header of section 2 is different than header of section 1. So now if I add page number here, it is going to work. But I also want to change the format of the page number. So I go to format page number, choose Roman numbers. That is the, and I want to start it at 1. So now I have Roman numbering for my table of contents pages, and the cover page has no page numbering. So again, I'm going to go to the header of third section. Make sure this is also not linked to the previous. Now I already have the page numbers here. I just want to put the word page, and I'll make it bigger to differentiate it visually from the earlier page numbering. And again, go to the number, format page number, and I want to start at 1. This is exactly what I want. One last thing to be done. I don't want this page 1 to be physically shown on the first page. When you go to header footer, there is something called different first page. The moment you do that, first page gets its own header. Page number is not shown, and page numbers are shown from page 2 onwards. So to summarize, our cover page has no page numbers. Table of contents have Roman numbers, and the actual content has numbers starting from 1 but not shown on first page, and everything works perfectly. That is how you manage table of contents in formal documents. I am sure you found this useful. Have I missed something? Is there a question you have in mind and you don't know the answer? Please post it in comments. I'll be happy to answer them. Share this with all your colleagues, friends, and loved ones so that they also benefit, and nobody around you should be creating table of contents manually. Even if you have subscribed, you like this video means YouTube is going to show it to more people and they become more efficient. So you are helping everyone else. And finally, I have a couple of videos about how to manage word tables. Have a look at those as well. So that's it for now. Thank you. See you next time.